welcome to the Happy Camber edition of the Arlington Catholic Herald. I'm staff writer Zoey.
And I'm Mike Flach, editor and general manager.
This summer, we've been busy covering the many wonderful camps going on in the diocese. Of course, earlier this summer, we had work camp in King George, Virginia, where hundreds of high school students fixed up homes for those in need. I've also seen a lot of great photos from vacation Bible schools at different parishes. I fondly remember my own time at Kids for Jesus VBS at St. Veronica Church. I'm glad for all the kids who can experience singing songs, doing crafts, playing games, and learning more about God at their church's VBS.
Sacred Heart Church in Winchester has an enormous and innovative summer camp running through August 23rd. The camp is in its first year, and 300 campers have already registered for more than 69 weekly summer camps at Summer at Sacred Heart, or SASH.
Assistant Director Chris Ricketts says the program is running well and it's helping young adults grow into leadership roles. He said, quote, "The program is meant to provide good camps for children, but also to evangelize and work with older kids, because that's one of the biggest groups of people leaving the church these days."
There's some good news on that front in our diocese as well. In July, 116 high school boys attended Quo Vadis, and 110 high school girls attended Fiat, camps held at Mount St. Mary Seminary in Emmitsburg, Maryland, that helped the young people discern their vocation. The seminarians at Quo Vadis and the religious sisters at Fiat helped the young men and women get a taste of what religious life might be like. The campers also heard from married couples about how they live out their vocation.
Just last week, I covered a very cool summer camp called Boot Camp for Aspiring Saints, hosted by a Holy Spirit church in Annandale. Every day was like a mini pilgrimage and a service trip rolled into one. One day, the campers visited Old Town Alexandria, where they got to meet the Daughters of St. Paul at their bookstore there, and visit Christ House, a men's shelter, thrift store, and food pantry run by Catholic Charities. The next day, I tagged along as they traveled to farms on the Northern Neck. There, they picked corn and donated it to local food pantries. A few days later, they went to the pantry and shucked and packaged the corn. Let's hear what the campers have to say about the experience.
Well, first we got onto the bus, went to pick corn for the people who are less fortunate and for this establishment, and then we went to the establishment, got a few popsicles along with the corn, saw where they kept the freezers and all that stuff, and now we're here.
Awesome. And what do you guys like about camp?
That we actually know where stuff is going to.
I really like the feeling of helping out everybody. And when like things got tough in the fields, like last year and this year, I just thought to myself, finish this, cause don't quit now. If you quit now, some little boy or girl ain't gonna have like dinner or lunch or something. I don't know.
Yeah, like in the fields, like. My friend, she was like, oh my gosh, when is it gonna end? I'm like, bro, we're doing this so people can, you know, so they can have corn. Because, you know, we're fortunate enough so that every night our parents have food on the table. But, so, you know, some kids can't have that.
There's a lot more on the Boot Camp for Aspiring Saints and SASH in our July 25th print edition. Or check the show notes for links to the articles on CatholicHerald.com. And Mike has some in-house news to share.
Yeah, in this week's Catholic Herald, Billy Atwell, the Chief Communications Officer for the Diocese of Arlington, announces a new vision and a new era for the Catholic Herald, which includes the change from a weekly print publishing schedule to a bi-weekly printing schedule beginning in September. In addition, the Catholic Herald will increase its circulation from 40% of registered households to 80%, thus doubling its circulation. The Catholic Herald must reach out to those struggling in their faith and who are enticed by increasing cultural secularization, Billy Atwell wrote. By inspiring, educating, and informing the Catholic faithful as an extension of the mission of our bishop, we will more completely evangelize our brothers and sisters in Christ. The Catholic Herald will deliver educational, inspiring, and informative content on a daily, weekly, and bi-weekly basis. Daily diocesan and church news will be found on the Catholic Herald's website, CatholicHerald.com, and those who wish to receive weekly stories, videos, and podcasts from the Catholic Herald are encouraged to subscribe to the weekly e-newsletter. And to sign up for free, go to the newspaper's website and look for newsletter sign up, or text ACHENews to 22828. The bi-weekly print schedule will allow the Catholic Herald to devote more time and energy to digital content, which will include podcasts, videos, and other social media efforts. In this week's print edition, Bishop Michael Burbridge wrote, "The Arlington Catholic Herald has been a powerful source of news and information for decades. By changing the publishing schedule, doubling the households we reach, further investing in digital media, and expanding the content offered, we will look back years from now and be even more proud of what we have built and the good work we have done. Naturally, the Herald will continue to evolve, as is the entire media industry. By adapting to a changing world, the Herald will remain a critical tool for inspiring, educating, and informing the faithful of this great diocese."
Thanks for sharing, Mike. It's a big change for all of us here. Start your print subscription today by emailing circulation@catholicherald.com or calling 703-841-2591. And if you're enjoying the show, please leave us a rating on iTunes, Stitcher, or wherever you listen. Thanks to Maraist Kyra Lopez for producing this episode.
Thanks for listening.